ladies and gentlemen, now it is time to move on to our first panel discussion. Also, keep hashtagging India Brand Conclave as one word. Keep tweeting, keep spreading the social buzz around this event. Well, ladies and gentlemen, now the topic of the panel discussion is steering intent, leveraging search for branding. Well, search advertising is now a part of brand marketers' standard toolkit. It no longer lies at the bottom of the marketing funnel. It's now seen to deliver influence throughout the customer journey. It has gone beyond clicks and conversions and now is used as a tool to steer the intent of target customers towards buying by engaging them, raising awareness, and increasing preference for the advertised brand. This session, ladies and gentlemen, will feature brands that found new ways to leverage search to build brands in recent IPL and festival seasons and will cover such aspects as understanding the existing and prospective customers, reaching them effectively and engaging and influencing them at the right moment. Well, ladies and gentlemen, with this, I now invite the leaders who will be sharing insights on the same. First up, Anubhav Sathalia, CEO, Merkel Sokrati, who will be joining us. Gaurav Shatak, Vice President and Head Digital Marketing, Sher Khan. Sandesh Gupta, SEO, Head Wakefit.co. And our session chair, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be Rohit Doshi, Director, Microsoft Advertising in Mobi. Thank you so much to our esteemed panelists for joining us and giving us your valuable time today. I welcome you all to the India Brand Conclave. With this, I pass it on to the able hands of Mr. Doshi for taking it forward with his esteemed panel. Over to you.
Thank you, Bhavna, for the quick and warm introduction. First of all, I'll really welcome everyone to the discussion today. I would also want to thank our panelists for joining us for today's session. But I think before we get into today's topic of discussion, just setting some context here and sharing some of the facts, on what has happened in the last 2 to 3 quarters, right? India as a market has undergone quite a lot of changes, right? All of us have been experiencing working in the new normal, working from home. I'm sure all of us are kind of, remotely working from home now. We're now used to doing things in a completely different way, right? From what it was 9 months before. Talking about the market as well, India has seen a massive growth in the internet users in the past 9 months, right? And we are probably on track on becoming one of the largest internet economies by the across the globe, right? With around 700 million users, which would be a 25% year-over-year growth. Now, understandable for millions of users across India, the internet begins with search, right? And most of us, I think it'll even start with a simple search query. On Microsoft Search itself, we've seen over 200 million active users searching, right? This has even increased immediately after the lockdown was put into effect, as everyone was searching for things around themselves, whether it was grocery shops, clinics, hospitals, etc. Also, we have seen some of the industries have witnessed a major growth in the past few months. For example, delivery-related terms saw a 210% growth on Microsoft Search. There are sectors such as e-learning, online courses, which have almost seen more than 500% growth on our platform itself. And, there is also definitely a lot of innovation that has, come into search advertising now, while all of us primarily use search for only performance. But I think in today's time, there is a lot of innovation happening and brands and marketers are innovating and using search across the funnel for also creating brand awareness. So I think with that thought in mind, I'll open up this panel discussion for our panelists here. And the topic for today's discussion is leveraging search for branding. So my first question to everyone in the panel would be, how have you been particularly using search advertising for your brand? Gaurav, do you want to get started?
Yes. So hi, everyone. And thank you, Rohit, for a great introduction about the topic which we are going to discuss today. So if I talk about my perspective on search, I think is a very, very important and very high intent based marketing tool, if I may use that word, to reach out to your target audience and so on and so forth. So search acts as a very, very important tool in whichever marketing you are doing, whether you are doing a brand marketing or for a performance, definitely it is very, very important medium to be used. and search over a period of time has evolved a lot. So it is very, very important. And probably if you have to look at which business you are in, which business cycle you are in, based on that, you can use search to your end business objectives. And it highly depends on which business industry you are in and probably at which business cycle are you an established brand or you are a startup or you are just starting off launching a new brand or something like that. So search is very, very important for any marketer in digital space. So I think one cannot live without search. How to use it, it depends what you want to achieve.
Thanks for sharing your thoughts on that, Gaurav. I totally agree with you that, you know, search is a high intent marketing tool. And I think there is a lot of evolution that has happened and completely depend upon which of the businesses that you're in. Anubhav, since I think you are in the unique position, right, of, you know, working with different brands, any thoughts on how do you think they have leveraged search advertising? Any use cases where, you know, brands with different verticals may be using in a specific way than others? And how brands are evolving their marketing strategies when it comes to search?
Yeah. So I can give you a bunch of examples actually, but I think quickly first I'll kind of like echo Gaurav's thoughts. It's highly dependent on I think what's your industry segment, what is that you are selling, and also on which sort of life cycle of the brand are you in basically. So for example, if you are just if you're a startup brand starting off, like search can be an insane tool to create brand awareness, right? Like fundamentally, brand creation is basically letting people know that you have a product and convincing them that you have the best product with whatever you have at your disposal. So if say for example, I'm a brand which has just started off, I can use search fairly comfortably to kind of create brand awareness and kind of convince people that I have a better product. I'm assuming I have a better product, of course. I mean, one example of this strategy being used was, I think, and I clearly distinctly remember, I think we used to work for Fashion In You, and I don't know how many of you guys used it in that time frame. It was like 6-8 years ago. And Rocket Internet had just launched Jabong in India at that point of time. And Fashion In You was obviously the incumbent well-known brand, and using something that you call competitor keywords, basically, Jabong started bidding overnight at, I don't know, like 500 rupees or I don't know whatever that cost was, but some insane cost. And I think the whole idea was to make a quick splash in the market against people who already knew Fashion In You, right? So they just basically wanted to go after people who knew Fashion In You and like let them know that there is a new player in town. And that's a fantastic example of creating awareness in a short burst with a very relevant sort of user set, which is already in the market buying something that you are also selling now, right? Like, so there, obviously, once they come to the Jabong website, it is Jabong's website's job to convince them that this is still the best, etc., etc. But I think it's a fabulous way of kind of making a first quick inroad. So I think there are multiple examples like that. I mean, but this is like one strategy that immediately comes to mind that people have used to create a quick brand impact. But again, I think it's dependent on where your life cycle is. So if you're a large FMCG brand and you're still kind of, you're just trying to create sustenance basically. Like say, for example, if you're a toothpaste, Colgate, right? I mean, I don't think creating search queries, I mean, more search queries there or tapping into the search queries is changing their business fundamentally, right? So you will see that they often go to very sort of top video heavy kind of channels where they are convincing more people to buy a Colgate. So they need to tell a different kind of story because the need for toothpaste is somewhat established. I think even for them, like I think if they looked at say voice search more closely, right, or they looked at vernacular search more closely, they would certainly find important pockets where they could still make the same impact that they were making using video or display. But you got to be creative about it. Like you got to kind of go and find pockets where you can make this impact. Sorry, I ran too long. I'll quickly.
I think those were some great insights and completely aligned to the fact that, you know, except for the big brands which have kind of already, you know, where everyone knows that they're there. But I think, you know, for the brands there that are still trying to kind of establish themselves in the market, it probably, you know, search would make more sense. So definitely it is again going to vary for verticals and different brands on how innovative they can be on using search itself. So completely, you know, aligned to that, Anubhav. And thanks for sharing those thoughts. Sandesh, do you want to share thoughts on, you know, how you have been using search advertising specifically for Wakefit and any learnings you have there? Do we have Sandesh on the call? Okay, I think there is some network issue, but anyway, we'll just continue going on this front. Any thoughts, you know, Gaurav and Anubhav? I think, like you mentioned, right?
Okay, so Rohit, meanwhile, when Sandesh joins, I can share, right, as I talked about that we have to look at in the where the industry you are in, where you are, right? So I can talk about, I'm managing two brands right now. One is Sher Khan and another new discount broker we have launched by the name of Espresso, which is 2-month-old brand. So I think search strategy for both the brands has to be very, very, very different, right? Because Espresso being new, as Anubhav also talked about it, that search can be used to reach out to your target audience and tell them that this is the product you have to offer. Whereas Sher Khan has been into market from last 20 years or so, the search strategy for Sher Khan has to be totally different. So I'm just giving one example of search where I'm managing both the brands. For both brands are at a different maturity level and have a very different kind of a business requirement. So search, as I also earlier said, is very, very important. I think whichever marketing you are doing, it's very important, but how much to leverage on search, because it's also a costly medium. Though it is very, very important, you can reach out, but ultimately it's also the cost factor. You also look at it that search is very, very important, but yes, if you have to do brand building, maybe for FMCG brand, maybe a video heavy campaign works well, then maybe a search heavy campaign. So I think that's one example I would like to share. I think Sandesh has also joined.
Sandesh, could you hear my question? I think I was, I want to
no,
kind
no,
of,
no.
Okay.
If you can just repeat one.
Sure. So I think we were discussing about, you know, depending upon how to use search completely depends upon, you know, the life cycle of the brand and probably, you know, the journey where you are into. I just wanted to check with you in terms of how you have been using search for your brand, given it's a direct to consumer brand. And I think, you know, I think Wakefit has done a tremendous progress in terms of, you know, establish itself. So anything in particular that on search strategies that has been working well for you?
So I think we are using search for basically both the funnels, your consideration phase as well as your, you know, bottom of the funnel where people are more, you know, driven towards, you know, purchase, because we are an online business. People are basically, you know, looking for all these important keywords like, you know, mattress online and all these things, right? So we are using search aggressively, primarily to drive highly efficient conversions and all. So I think search has always been an important pillar in terms of our marketing. And I think since beginning, recently also we have launched a new furniture segment, right? We are also launching all the new furniture segments. Previously it was just mattress and the sleep solutions. So from day one, you know, what we have seen that the moment we have started the search campaigns for those, we have started seeing, you know, good incremental transactions in terms of the orders and all. So it has always played an important role. As I mentioned, I think we are using search in both the phases, not just for, you know, getting the new audience, even like using it for the remarketing phase, right? Like running some remarketing list based ads and all. I think this has also seen, although it is a little expensive, but whenever that, because the kind of brand we have, right, it requires a lot of exploration. Let's say if I'm selling a sofa, right, it's not very easy, you know, that people are coming and then they're just buying, right? They will do a proper research and then they will, you know, come back for their final transaction, right? So hence it is very important, right, that, you know, whenever they're looking in their entire journey of the user, right, we are using different type of keywords, whatever they're looking for, either it is informative, either it is transactional, right? And then we are tapping the user into their entire journey. So I think we have used search across the entire user journey. And I think in the end, again, I would like to say that, you know, it is helping us and it is an important you know channel where you can look for you know the overall brand growth.
Sure. Thanks. Thanks, Sandesh, for sharing your thoughts on that. You know, clearly, I think you have been using search across the funnel. I would also want to quickly ask, you know, Anubhav and Gaurav, you know, what are your thoughts around trend checking and you know, probably, you know, focusing your campaign strategies probably more around events such as IPL or anything else? I think why I'm asking this question is recently, and I think in most of the cases, right, we have seen a lot of search queries increase with respect to certain events that happen in the industry, right? Or probably even, you know, smaller events such as even some viral videos, right? I think all of us have, you know, come across this video, Rasode Mein Kaun Tha, right? And what we saw was while people were kind of going bazooka on watching that video, there were a lot of search queries happening and people were actually searching for that video. Now, this ideally could be, you know, one of those moments where you know, any brands with innovative messaging, right, or even creative messaging could actually, you know, probably capture that those search queries and that demand and probably traffic, right? So what are your thoughts on, you know, let's say trendjacking or, you know, moment marketing, probably I would say on specifically, you know, doing this on search? And do you think, again, you know, while there is going to be one portion in terms of where the brand is in stage of its journey, but you know what, how do you think this strategy kind of, you know, playing around for brands and you know, any thoughts around that? Anubhav, want to go first?
Yeah, sure. So, see, I think it's an interesting sort of phenomena, right? Like, but I mean, at some level, to be very honest, I feel that it only adds limited value because it is very tough to like capture trends in real time, firstly, and then come up with something creative. I know that a bunch of people are doing it. I think like the likes of Zomato, Netflix, etc. do it pretty well on, I think, Twitter, right? But they are actually using the content as amplification from thereof, then capturing this on search. But I think like somebody who has a setup like that can certainly do this same thing to capture interest on search as well, right? Like there is absolutely no doubt. And you can see search queries go through the roof around some of these, and not by like an insignificant number, like by a seriously significant number. And like, I think we are we're in a very interesting, I think, juncture of a society where the entire world, I think, takes notice of something for a day and then collectively forgets it the next day. It's both very interesting and unfortunate, I think, but minus my commentary on social issues. So I think it can be done, right? Like, I think more importantly, I think for people who are, say, who have content plays itself, right? Like brands who have fundamentally aggregation plays around content, like for example, say a Daily Hunt or the likes of them, or I think we've done this pretty well for like Saavn back in the day. I think continuously mining for search queries with the trends, it becomes even more useful to capture meaningful traffic, which creates sort of value, right? So like if I had to really think of trend capturing or trend jacking, as you called it, like I think that would be one set of brands where I would really put a lot of effort in search to do this, because I think you're talking of some serious numbers that can be driven using this, and they obviously have the content as well to play along with it, right, around it. I think that's something that I would think about. How meaningful is it for a mainstream brand to do it? I mean, arguable, right? Like it does have a very nice sound to it, but when it comes to hard numbers, it's very arguable what the kind of volume is, because it usually then revolves around creating some kind of content in and around that so that you are a relevant page itself, right? Or else you be in the zone that Gaurav was saying, where basically it just becomes too expensive and unviable to run it like that.
Sure. Yeah, I think, you know, nice thoughts on that, Anubhav. I think, Gaurav, you want to add to, you know, what Anubhav mentioned, and what are your thoughts on you know, anything?
So what I can add to what Anubhav said is, I think the digital world we are in and we all are operating in, nothing can be ruled out. I think first my answer to this would be test and learn. rather than taking something which maybe Gaurav is saying or somebody is saying, right? So you can always test and learn, but based on my experience across search, I think because again of expensive medium A, B, for some trend like this, you need to create a content also very fast. What you're going to tell to the customer, right? For example, if Rasode mein kaun tha and maybe it is some, let's say pressure cooker brand or I don't know, some kitchen appliances brand or something like that, can create some content around very fast related to their category. Or maybe some other trend where they you directly know that this is my TG and he is talking about this. Maybe as a digital marketer, there is something which we all are interested in, and there is some trend happening on that. And maybe a digital marketing agency or some service provider wants to reach out and he knows exactly that my TG is talking about this. Then definitely it makes a lot of sense. And second part to it is at what cost? Because if it's a cost of reach to my target audience, right? If that click is coming at nobody and there's a huge volume and which is non-monetized and let's say each click is coming at 1 rupee or maybe less than a rupee or something like that, definitely go for it, right? So my suggestion would be, I think you cannot rule out. I think one should test and learn. But for a mainstream brand, because numbers will not add up, right? If you're an FMCG brand, probably you can reach out to millions and billions of customers maybe through some other video channel or some other channel, right? Maybe search, if that is generating that kind of a huge volume, at what cost you are reaching out to them. I think if I can sum it up, I think one can test and learn and see whether it is working for your brand and not. But definitely cost is going to be an important element to look at the success of it.
Sure. Yeah, I think with a lot of, teams, as of now, I mean, within the brands itself, in-house, and then, you know, there are digital agencies wherein a lot of automation has come into place. A lot of this, you know, innovative strategies of testing, campaigns is possible. So I think, yeah, definitely, you know, something worth, trying and exploring. Sandesh, my question to you would be, I think a lot of this you have been testing for some time, right? And I think you have done a lot of work in, capturing things around IPL and probably creating messaging which resonates with IPL for Wakefit as a brand, and also have been, able to use the high intent audience in certain shape and form. Could you share some insights on, what has really worked for you?
Yeah, definitely, Rohit. So I think I'll align with Gaurav. So initially our thought process was same, only that, let's do some, create some video. And we have done this Bablu Carpenter campaign during this IPL time, where we have created, multiple videos regarding around the IPL theme, and, we have launched it across YouTube and all. But I think then we have also realized that, why not to capture? And I think this is what, we have just tried and tested to run, search specific campaign on the IPL queries where people are looking for, the scores, the live, IPL matches and, keywords like that. And with the help of, Microsoft search advertising, right, where, we have used all these keywords with our right intent, basically the right match type to get the right intent of the, users. We have seen a decent performance, from this particular campaign. Reason being that, one, I think it's not very straightforward when you are saying or doing a branding on a search platform, right? Because intent is still different, but the way you are putting your ad copies, the way you are, putting your message in front of the user will again come in picture, right? So what different products, whatever we have, again, we have thought of adding, those products along with the keywords, right? What people are looking for. So for example, if someone is, let's say, looking for IPL score, IPL, match, IPL live streaming, right? So what we have done, basically, we've used ad copies in a very quick way. Basically, we have just written something like, watch IPL on sitting or Wakefit sofa, or, watch IPL on your TV inside a nice TV unit from Wakefit. So all this, different product association we have done in all those ad copies. The result outcome, what I can say is that, whatever campaign we are running on the branded, non-branded campaign, where we are seeing the transactions and the orders and the right traffic on important keywords. So I think this brand campaign has also contributed roughly around 40 to 50% of that search traffic. And the idea, how we have used it, again, because since we are using, or we have also created a specific landing pages onto our website, where we are also running one specific campaign, which is like Wakefit Free Hit, where if a user is purchasing the, you know, product during the window of that IPL, which is, you know, 7:30 to 11:30, we are going to, you know, just, you know, provide the entire, you know, cashback to these guys. So that is one more campaign, you know, which we have again aligned with, you know, this thing. And the success was good. The traffic was good. Also, I would say that, you know, we have seen some, since it's a branding campaign, so you cannot expect a good amount of, you know, final conversions, but still we have seen a decent convergence from that campaign. The good part, what I can say about the traffic, right, whether the, you know, the people are coming. So the bounce rate of that traffic, as well as the average session duration, people who are coming, right, was also pretty much similar to the non-branded, you know, keyword researches. So I think this is one very important thing what we have observed, and we have then increased the budget as well, you know, after running the campaign for a week or so, just to get, or just to, you know, milk out that kind of a traffic in order to, you know, get a better outcome for the, you know, campaign. And then we have started running some remarketing campaigns as well on those users who have, you know, visited the traffic through all these, you know, IPL related keywords. So all this has, you know, in order to sum up, I would say that, you know, it was a success for us in terms of getting the traffic from the very, you know, non-branded, or you can say the territory is itself very different, right? We are working in a mattress and furniture keyword segment. And when we are tapping into that IPL kind of a keyword, so bringing that traffic and then, you know, trying to convert those users, and it has helped. So I think what we have learned basically is that, you know, if you're creating the right messaging, if you are creating the right landing pages for your user, if it is still not very much related to your brand, still you can, you can do branding on search, and you can try to bring the right traffic and convergence as well in the longer run.
Thanks, Sandesh, for those detailed insights. I think clearly, I think you have had innovative content across different funnel, and then, you know, use search and then topped it up with remarketing and several other features, which has clearly worked for you. Thanks for sharing those insights. You know, moving on to the next question, you know, Anubhav, as someone, you know, who has worked with several brands, how do you see the adoption of, you know, voice and search, you know, coming along in the years to come? You know, one is with the next 100 or probably 200 million users coming online, a lot of them probably might not be actually searching, comfortable searching by themselves, right? Or probably might not search themselves. So how do you see that, you know, the voice and search play coming along, and any thoughts on that for you know, the marketers out there?
So see, the truth is that currently the sort of adoption is limited, to be very honest, right? Like, I think few people have done some campaigns more around innovation, etc. I don't think that the adoption from a advertising standpoint is immense at the moment, right? But that's the very current situation. Now you look at, I think, 2 years from today, and I mean, this is my prediction, but I think 2 years from today, my sense is the adoption, and this will become more and more mainstream. Because if you look at the numbers closely, the queries are actually there. The volume of queries is quite insane on both voice search and vernacular search. Right, so vernacular, we have started adopting it for our customers. We've started adopting vernacular search as a medium to advertise for search advertising for our customers. And it's basically very untapped, so we see great results at the moment. Right, on voice, honestly, there is no ad product at the moment for people to even adopt. You could do interesting content stuff on voice at the moment, nothing that is a pure play advertising product. But if you look at the number of queries, you will be amazed. And actually what's happening increasingly is that there is a large part of the new India that is joining the internet, for whom voice is a much more natural interface to the internet or to a computer or a phone than text. So I think when people used to talk to me earlier about voice search, I used to always be amazed and confused actually as to why I would why would I use the phone, sort of, why would I use voice to do a query? And now that I look at it increasingly, especially with Alexa or say Google Home is just a directional understanding, while the number of devices are nowhere close to making an impact. But actually, people do, like, once you get used to the voice interface, actually typing seems like a hassle, because typing is actually very unnatural to the human nature, right? Like, we were built for voice. So it's when you find a device on the other side which is built for voice and comfortable with it. And I see the same thing happening on phones, right? Like, people have gotten comfortable talking to their phones and using voice search, especially if your vernacular, etc., typing is not easy. Like, I think the issue is that we are very English focused, right, in our heads, because we grew up with English. So we find it a little tough to imagine the hardcore old school sort of vernacular user. So I think the best thing to do is you look at, if you look at my mom, etc., you will find them typing, or speaking more to the phone than typing. And I think that is when you realize the sort of power of voice in general. So I think it's just that you have to look closely. My sense is few years, I think they'll break out some kind of voice advertising product as well and start monetizing queries. The volume of queries exists. Today there is nobody who's monetizing it. There is no mechanism to easily monetize it. And I think that's where we are kind of seeing some gaps sort of at the moment.
Sure. Yeah, I think thanks for sharing those thoughts. I think built for voice is, something that will be stuck with me for a long time. So thanks for, sharing your thoughts on that. Gaurav, any thoughts on that, on the same thing, which is vernacular and voice in search, and, what are your thoughts on that?
So I think on vernacular, I think there's a lot of search happening, and I think it's the brand now who has to invest in vernacular, right? Because just having a vernacular search and showing an English ad and bringing him to an English landing page is not going to work, right? But there's a huge, I think, growth is which is happening in vernacular. I think there has to be investment done from a brand side. Definitely search, and I'm sure the business is there. Whereas when it comes to voice, I can share my first experience when I saw the future is going to be about voice. So I came to my native and there was a small young girl, 3 years old. She went to her mother and told her, Mama, Mama, Nani Moni, Nani Moni. I don't know what she was saying. She took her phone, unlocked the phone, opened the YouTube, 3-year-old girl, and went to YouTube through voice search, said Nani. She wanted to hear Nani Teri Moni ko more lege. So Nani Moni, she was not able to speak properly also. And she opened Nani Moni, saw Nani Moni, and she was happy. So I think this kind of new customers who are coming, if you are the Barbie of the world and you want to target her, probably she is there, right? Before she can write and say something. So voice right now, if I say, as Anubhav also mentioned, how to monetize, what need to be done, I think it will take a couple of more time, but yes, search are happening. People are doing a lot of search, but definitely product has to come. But vernacular, I think it is there. I think as 5-10 years back, we were talking about mobile. Now I think it is going to be more vernacular, but I think voice is another thing which probably right now you may not be able to show the ROIs to the CEO and CXOs of your company. But this is something which is about to come maybe in a year's time, depend which business you are in and so forth, other things. But I'm sure some business use case of voice will start coming soon, right? Where it is adding value. That's what my experience with voice and vernacular has.
Sure, yeah. You've given me a goal, Gaurav. I think I need to teach my 2-year-old daughter how to search on YouTube so that she stops bugging me.
So, yeah, I think I agree that, probably the ROI, maybe it's too soon to comment, and probably, the ROI at this point in might make sense or not. But like you mentioned, I think, testing is again going to be the key. Back at you, Anubhav, to kind of also, take your opinion on what do you think, what will it take to make voice mainstream, right? So one is, probably making it simpler, having the use of devices. Probably, I think once you use it, like you mentioned, it's more intuitive, and that's what, naturally we kind of, prefer. But I think, making it mainstream and then using and bringing it as a part of, the tools, which is not there currently, right? Probably, there aren't solutions to, offer and monetize on top of that. What do you think is going to be a game changer in that?
No, Rohit, actually, I am being honest. I think it is already mainstream. To say that what will it take mainstream is somewhat of a misplaced question, to be honest. Like, because I think if you look at the numbers, right, the sheer numbers tell us that it is already mainstream. Like when 100 plus million people start searching in a particular segment, I think you will quickly realize that we can't call it non-mainstream anymore. Now, I think obviously once say Microsoft or a Google or any of these guys come up with a sort of advertising product in and around it, I think advertising will pick up. Like, I think today really the issue is that most of the advertising that you could do around it has to be extremely creative driven, extremely content driven, and people are doing it, right? Like, people are doing it where people have built out skills on Alexa, etc. And people kind of doing stuff, but they're mostly innovation driven at the moment than volume driven, because there is no easy distribution that's come out. Right? I mean, advertising at the end of the day is a distribution mechanism. So there's no easy distribution mechanism at the moment, but I'm pretty sure that like couple of years, like once there are enough queries, I mean, a Google and Microsoft, everybody has the incentive to monetize them, right? So I'm sure there is a product in the works sooner than later. And I think that as soon as that happens, we'll start seeing it pick up. That's what I'm saying. It may take a couple of years, but it will pick up. I don't think it is the lack of usage. Like, I think a few years back, I would have said maybe there's a lack of usage, but right now there is no lack of usage. Like, there is enough people doing significant amount of volume on search.
Yeah, I think I do recall from one of the conversations earlier, also that, probably personalization is what is also going to be important, when there is a product, and if there is, in a couple of years, I think, one is searching and probably, coming up with something which is more monetizable, but then personalization is also going to, play that key at scale, right? So, moving on, I think we have 10 more minutes left. I want to also check with all of you. I mean, what are the technological advancements or trends that for the search marketers out there, any trends or technological advancements that you would recommend them to follow for the audience out here for the session who are joined. If you could kind of recommend that something that you want to recommend to the marketers out there, both for the brands which are relatively newer, and probably for the brands that have been there for some time, anything that you would want to recommend to the audience out here.
Yeah, I think I can mention a few sort of ideas. I think there is site links. I don't know how many people. I mean, like, the people who work on search would know it, obviously. I think there is basically, this is just a way to enhance the quality of the ad. I think they are pretty critical. I think there is a bunch of interesting integrations that at least on Google is available in form of, I forget what they're exactly called, but in form of countdown timers, etc. And I think they are very interesting innovations that can be done sort of to power more interesting advertising. So, like, we remember that we've set up a campaign once to kind of provide health insurance coverage for people in geographies with poorer air quality index. And you could fill in a number basically saying that your current air quality index is, say above 500, and you should seriously think about getting a health insurance cover. Right, and that campaign had like great impact. So I think there are a bunch of such tools that are relatively underused in search, which create significant impact on the business. So I think that's something that I would recommend people to think about a little bit and try out. But end of the day, I think digital marketing, or I think the internet, is about testing out things continuously and learning more and more. And everybody goes through their own journey. So they'll have to go through that journey and kind of figure some of these things out. But those are a couple of ideas that I think people can do and create a massive impact.
Sure. Yeah, I think thanks for that. I think super helpful for the audience, who have joined the discussion. Gaurav, you want to add any thoughts to that?
So if I can give some suggestions, I think one is definitely test and learn. Nobody knows the what will work for your brand. So I think how you can create a culture of maybe controlled way testing, maybe and at the same point in time delivering your business results, right? So there has to be constant rapid testing happening. So you always should be testing new ideas, new tools which are coming in, probably new things which Google, Microsoft or other partners are putting in. Second thing which I will also recommend is, for example, right now we talked about voice search. Apart from the product will come, but how this voice search works, right? Please spend some time in skill enhancement, understand how this is no magic, right? Maybe 5 years back, this voice search was not giving that kind of a great result. Right now it is giving a great result. As I talked about, some young girl was searching and was the intent was understood by the search, how these things work. So please do invest some time in understanding this stuff. Once you understand them, I think you are in a better position to A, evaluate the tool which comes to your disposal. B, also are able to use it well. C, you can also customize to your business requirement. But till the time we will not invest time into it, it will not help. So that's what I will suggest. And there is an interesting TED talk which talks about any skill can be learned in 20 hours, for 20 hours of learning. So you don't have to become expert as a, you don't have to become a, maybe let's say AI engineer or something like that. But definitely because you are using a lot of them and taking a lot of risk, a lot of money of the businesses being used by you. So you should understand it well so that you can guide your company or guide your business in this digital world. So these are probably two suggestions I can give.
Sure. Thanks. Super helpful, Gaurav. I think, you know, testing, you know, I agree that testing is going to be the key. And then, you know, there are newer advancements that are going to come in. So I think, you know, probably trying and testing a lot of them is, I mean, what works for your brand is probably something that you'll only know after you test it. Sandesh, any tips for the marketers out there, you know, that you want to give?
I think I'll align with Gaurav because experimentation is the key. And I think we in Wakefit also, you know, run multiple, you know, A-B testing on multiple, you know, campaigns, being on keywords, being on landing pages and all. I think that one should always follow. But yeah, I think you have to consider a specific budget. The pilot budget should be there. It should not, you know, be something like that, you know, just spending money without looking into the results. So I think balance between the experimentation, also between your ROI, is a very important parameter. Apart from that, I think from the new thing, I would like to, you know, I think the extensions are playing a decent role across all the search platform. I would also like to see, you know, I think we have a decent extension right now, but I think in SEO, we can see, you know, the review and rating extensions, right? And primarily when you are in e-com, right, it's very important for any business when you are showing this, you know, product related these things, right? So I think that extension right now is not there. So if we can work on few of these extension, I think personally like this button extension from Microsoft Search, right, where, you know, it's coming very clearly that, you know, there is a button where you can click and, you know, you can you know, take the user to the right page and all. So I think all these extensions are the helping or the supporting element when you're putting any advertisement in front of a user. So I think those kind of extension should, again, we can thought of looking for new extension, you know, trying out multiple things. So I think that can be a value add. I think one more thing, what I was just thinking that, you know, right now, even shopping search is very, you know, in the e-com segment again, right? So it's very booming. So if you can, again, you know, do some kind of a, you know, combination between your search and the shopping ads, or, you know, even on the search queries, if let's say we have started showing some of the images, right? That might be a new thing. So I was just thinking, you know, that, you know, that might, again, become a very new thing if, you know, if you're looking for such kind of changes, the way we are, you know, putting the ads in front of the user. Because I think when people are looking onto the images, they will, you know, track towards it and they will try to, you know, click it furthermore, right, rather than just seeing the text. So I think that is my whole thing on this.
Sure. Thanks. I think, yeah, I think that brings us to the end of session. I'll hand it over to you, Bhavna. I think, I don't know if we have like a couple of minutes because we have a few questions on the chat. I think if we could take
that. Rohit, we're a little on the hard stop because our next speaker is right there and we're on schedule at 4:40. So, but I'd really like to thank Rohit, Anubhav, Gaurav and Sandesh for joining us and being a part of the panel discussion. This was our first panel discussion at the India Brand Conference. So thank you all for giving us your valuable time.